Hi students, how are you? In last class, we have already discussed about water cycle, carbon cycle, nitrogen cycle and all. So today, we can discuss about oxygen cycle. Okay, so we know the importance of oxygen and we know that about 21% of the atmosphere contains oxygen. And it also occurs in combined form as carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, etc. And in the crust, it is formed as oxides of most metals and silicon and also as carbonate, sulfate, nitrate and other minerals. So it occurs in elemental form and it occurs in a combined form also. And it is also an essential component of most biological molecules like carbohydrates, proteins, nucleic acids and fats. Okay, so in all these forms we can see what oxygen. Now we can look how the percentage of oxygen is kept constant in the atmosphere. We saw that about 21% of the atmosphere contains oxygen. Now how that percentage is kept constant, through which all processes oxygen is taken in and through which all processes oxygen is given out. Oxygen from the atmosphere is used up in three processes, that is for combustion, respiration and in the formation of oxides of nitrogen. So for combustion, you know, for burning, oxygen is needed. Without oxygen, combustion won't take place. So for combustion, oxygen is used up and carbon dioxide gas is given out. So for combustion, oxygen is used up. Then next process is respiration. For respiration also, we know all living things are taking in oxygen. And respiration means the process of breaking down our food to release energy, water and carbon dioxide. So for getting energy, we are using oxygen. Okay, so for the process of respiration also, we are using oxygen. And this oxygen is used for the formation of nitrates and nitrites. That is formed by microbial oxidation process. Oxygen is used for combustion, respiration and in the formation of oxides of nitrogen. Okay. Now, through which process oxygen is given out? It is returned to the atmosphere in only one major process and that is photosynthesis. You know, photosynthesis is the process of preparation of food by plants in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll by using water and carbon dioxide. So in this process, during the preparation of food, plants give out which gas? Plants give out oxygen gas. So oxygen is released during this process of photosynthesis. Is it clear? So we are taking in through the process of combustion, respiration and in the formation of oxides of nitrogen. And through which process we are giving back this oxygen, or through which process it is returned back into the atmosphere? The oxygen is returned back into the atmosphere through the process of photosynthesis. Okay, so the level or amount of oxygen in the atmosphere is kept constant. How much we are using, that much amount is returned back into the atmosphere also. Okay, so it works as a cycle. Some amount is coming in and some amount is going back into the atmosphere also. Now you can look at the picture of oxygen cycle. So atmospheric oxygen is taken in by plants and animals through the process of respiration. For respiration, plants and animals take in oxygen. So respiration means breaking down of food to release energy, carbon dioxide and water. So they will use oxygen for the process of respiration. And during respiration, along with energy, what is given out? Carbon dioxide and water is given out. So carbon dioxide is given out, water is given out. Now this plants during photosynthesis, they utilize both this carbon dioxide and water. So this carbon dioxide and water is used or taken in by plants for the process of photosynthesis or for preparing food. And when plants prepare food, they are giving out water. They are giving out oxygen. So the oxygen is going back into the atmosphere itself. And along with during photosynthesis, the oxygen is given out. And what is formed? organic molecules or food is formed, that is C6H12O6 glucose is formed. And who is using this glucose? Plants and animals are using it during in the process of respiration for breaking it to release energy. Okay, so it is a this is oxygen cycle. Is it clear? Okay, so we know oxygen is very important for life in the process of respiration. But we can see there are some bacteria which are poisoned by elemental oxygen. They are anaerobes, so that they do not need oxygen for the process of respiration. We are aerobes, so we need what? We have aerobic respiration, so we need oxygen for respiration. But anaerobic respiration, for that anaerobes don't want oxygen. This respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen. And even in the process of nitrogen fixing also, we can see some bacteria can fix nitrogen in the absence of oxygen. Okay, so some oxygen is given back into, returned back into the atmosphere through the process of photosynthesis, and it is taken in for the process of respiration, combustion and formation of oxides. So the amount of oxygen in the atmosphere is always kept constant. So oxygen cycle is clear, no? So now we can discuss our next topic, that is ozone layer. We know that oxygen is O2. Oxygen is O2. Oxygen molecule is made up of two atoms of oxygen combined together. And oxygen gas, it is essential for life because it is needed for living things in the process of respiration. And ozone is O3. Ozone is O3. Okay, so it is made up of three atoms of oxygen combined together. So oxygen means two atoms of oxygen. Ozone have three atoms of oxygen. Now we can look how ozone is formed. So it is formed high up in the atmosphere by the action of ultraviolet radiation on oxygen gas. So high up in the atmosphere, what happens? This oxygen molecule, due to the action of ultraviolet radiation, this oxygen molecule splits into free oxygen atoms. So it due to ultraviolet radiation, it splits into two oxygen atoms, O and O. And this free oxygen atoms are very reactive. So one oxygen atom reacts with another oxygen molecule to form ozone molecule. So what happens? These are very reactive. So these oxygen atoms will combine with another oxygen molecule and it forms O3 or ozone. Okay. So due to high up in the atmosphere, ultraviolet radiations will split oxygen molecule into two atoms of oxygen, and these two atoms of oxygen, when they are released, they will combine with another oxygen molecule and form ozone. Okay, and at a height between 15 kilometer to 60 kilometer, there is a layer of ozone gas in the upper atmosphere. So it is taking place higher, high up in the atmosphere. So high up in the atmosphere, we can see there is a layer of ozone gas. So ozone, that is a gas, and we can see a layer of ozone gas in the high up in the atmosphere. Okay, and this ozone gas, actually it is a poisonous gas. It is dangerous for our life, but it is not stable nearer to the earth's surface. So ozone gas is formed high up in the atmosphere. It is not formed, it is not stable in nearer to the earth's atmosphere. So it is not affecting us. It is actually a poisonous gas. So high up in the atmosphere, we can see a layer of ozone. Okay. And this ozone layer is very important for the existence of life on earth. Ozone gas is poisonous, but this ozone layer that is present high up in the atmosphere, that is very important for the existence of life on earth. Why? Because it absorbs most of the harmful ultraviolet radiations coming from the sun and prevents them from reaching the earth. So what happens?
here sun is there, so ultraviolet radiations are coming to the surface of the earth, coming to the earth. What happens? This ozone layer that is present high up in the atmosphere, that will prevent the ultraviolet radiation. So this will absorb, this ozone layer will absorb most of the harmful ultraviolet radiations that is coming from the sun. It will absorb the ultraviolet radiation so that this harmful radiations won't come to the earth. Otherwise, if it come to the earth, what happens? It is harmful for the life on the earth. Okay. So this ozone layer absorbs most of the harmful ultraviolet radiations coming from the sun and prevents them from reaching the earth's surface. Okay. And the ultraviolet radiations have extremely harmful effects on human beings and other animals also. It may cause skin cancer, it affects our eyes, it affects our immunity system, so many problems. Thus, it is the ozone layer in the upper atmosphere which protects us from these diseases by absorbing the ultraviolet rays coming from the sun. And it has now been found that the amount of ozone is getting depleted. So now what is happening? The amount of ozone layer is getting depleted. It is getting thinner and thinner day by day. Okay, so what is happening? The depletion of ozone layer is due to the use of chemicals called CFCs. CFC means chlorofluorocarbons, compounds, carbon compounds that contain chlorine and fluorine. So these CFCs are the chemicals which are widely used in refrigerators, air conditioners and all. So CFCs released into the air react with ozone gas. So the CFCs that are used that will go and react with this ozone gas, and what happens? It will destroy it gradually. So this, it will react with this ozone gas and destroy the ozone layer, and the ozone layer is getting thinner and thinner day by day. So due to this, the ozone layer in the upper atmosphere has become thinner, allowing more ultraviolet rays to pass through it to the earth. So when it becomes thin, what happens? More ultraviolet radiations are coming to the earth. Thus, due to the depletion of ozone layer caused by CFCs, more ultraviolet radiations are reaching the earth. If the ozone layer in the atmosphere disappears completely, so it is becoming thinner and thinner. So if it disappears completely, what happens? Then all the extremely harmful ultraviolet radiations coming from the sun would reach the earth. Then all the life on the earth would be destroyed gradually. So now a hole is found in the ozone layer above Antarctica. So we should work towards stopping all further damages to the ozone layer. And in your textbook, you can see a photo or satellite picture showing the hole in the ozone layer above Antarctica. And year after year, what happens? The size is becoming larger. So we should be careful while using all these CFCs and all. So we should do something to stop all further damage to the ozone layer. So our lesson, natural resources, is over. Clear now? Okay, bye.